As long as I have to.
A Fort Myers Beach man is protesting the town's permitting process by living on the roof of his garage. Rick Loffrey says the town approved tens of thousands of dollars in Ian repairs to his garage, but now they're saying it has to be torn down.
Tonight, NBC2's Gage Golding is talking with him live there tonight about his unique protest.
Yeah, it's a small little thing, but it's a really big deal. I want you to take a look at what you kind of see is the outline of what looks like a home. Well, it was their home that was kind of right up against, I want to use the word attached, but with air quotes here. That's flushing, and it's a kind of like a weatherproofing to prevent water coming from down in there. And this is what the town is kind of getting stuck up on, is that this flushing, they say, actually attaches this structure to the actual home. And this garage was built back in 2019. And you can see it's still standing. Now, because it's attached in the town's eyes, that means because the home is falling under the 50-50 rule, this would have to be torn down. But Rick and his wife Amy say, no, not so fast. This isn't attached. Actually, the town themselves approved a couple permits for them to do about $25,000 worth of work to get this garage back to the way it was before Hurricane Ian. And Amy, you're here with me right now. $25,000, that's not just a drop in the bucket. That's a lot of money.
Yes, it is.
I mean, what are your thoughts knowing that that could just be going down the drain?
Well, it's not comforting, that's for sure. So, and it would be money that we could have spent on our new home instead.
And you're actually trying to get that new home built, but the permit was denied because of this.
Yes, that is correct. So now we're at a standstill until we can get this resolved.
Drives you up a wall or maybe up on the roof, huh?
Yes.
What do you think about your husband being camped out up there?
I'm very proud of him for what he's doing.
And it's for not just you, it's for other people, right?
That is correct. We're trying to bring awareness to our entire island and our community, and not just that we're suffering, but that our community and our town needs help.
And Amy, Rick, he's up there right now. And Rick, we got you. It's kind of sprinkling a little bit out here, but you were weathering all the storm, all the weather. How are you faring up there right now? About as good as you can
get,
right?
Thank you.
Why is it so important to be up there? Not just for you and your family, but for the other folks as well. You're making a statement that's being seen around Florida.
Well, I hope so. You know, I hope that our leaders see it and, you know, make change. You know, they were here after the storm. We just want them to come back and give
and
us a hand.
FEMA, we've been talking about FEMA, FEMA 50-50 rule. Representatives from FEMA actually visited you in your house today. How'd that conversation go?
It went okay. They came and looked, at least, and you know that's what we've been asking for the whole time, is for somebody to come look and give their answers to our architect.
Did get you any answers, or answers enough to get you off the roof? Close.
No,
well, hey, we got some answers from the town of Fort Myers Beach, Rick, and they kind of gave three solutions. One would be to bring the garage here up to code and then attach it to a new home that you're going to build, but that would also include a lot of money. The second would be to leave this detached, bring it up to code, and then build a detached house. Also, a lot of money there. And then the third would be to just bulldoze it, which nobody wants to do. Now, you know, some people might be like, why doesn't the town look the other way? And there's a good answer for that. The answer is because the town is part of the National Flood Insurance Program. And what that does is it drops rates for everybody here on the island. Now, if they look the other way, they could jack some of those rates up, or it could even let the town lose out on future FEMA dollars. So this is important. But Rick, he's going to be up on that roof until something happens. I'm reporting live and local on Fort Myers Beach. Gage Golding, NBC2.